Without further ado, let's get going. Hey, Serp, back you fall. How y'all been? That's probably correct. I don't remember if I have a significant number of souls in the room up there either, you know? Probably a better way to run past those guys. Also. Hey girl, hey! I really like her movement set, it's really awesome. Doesn't look like there's actually any souls there, so I don't have to worry about that going forward. My first attempt, I think I got her to phase 2 without getting hit at all, so. Already doing worse than that. Ouch. I think she might be able to attack through that thing, I'm not sure. Try to be careful about it. Do some kind of shenanigan with it. I don't know if that fire over there is like actual will damage me if I get into it fire. Ouch. Double ouch. Triple ouch. Oh, that's fun. What happened to me that time last time, too? Ow, 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 ow. Now's the time to use that, right? When I get a really big heal. So much for that point. Round 2, now she's got 2 swords. And a new song. Seems like that is very sweet whenever she does that, you know? Looks like she's going to do a third attack there, but I don't think she ever does. I'm not 100% sure about that yet. Okay, she'll do a spin attack after her big jump there. Keep that in mind. Ouch, ouch, ouch. I think the next attempt will go pretty well. We had more ether for Estus Flask. Golden. It's just 2 swings, I guess. I wonder if I had just continued attacking Titan her range there, if I could have killed her at the end there. This is a really cool fight, though. Her animation set feels pretty different from the other bosses in the series so far, so it's pretty exciting to fight her. Hey, Game Saucer, Yahan, how's it going, guys? That was a pretty good coming back after a weak attempt. Still not as good as my first, right? My first, I think I still had 4 Estus flasks left when I died, and I got her to phase 2 without getting hit. Reproducing that success is going to be a challenge here. I'm still okay with using embers in boss fight. Looks like the boss is kind enough to let you heal. Pretty good. Let's forget the souls. Anything in there? Shit. But I'm just out of range up there. Should have actually gotten some hits in there. It was kind of a waste. Would have been a good time to use the ember as well. Maybe I want to get a little bit further in the fight before I do it up there. That might be death. I don't know if I have quite enough hit points to survive that. Let's see if it says you died at the end there. Yeah, that's death. So if we let her grab us anywhere far from like 90% health, we're basically dead. So gotta be a little bit more careful attacking her from the front there. Let's try again. I think once she gets her second sword, she loses that grab. Maybe she has some other attack that hits really, really hard from low health. But bad at using embers, yeah. I probably never would have used them if... I think that having it so that it heals you to full, but only if you're not already enkindled, is a really good balance solution for it. Having it as an emergency item use. Now would be a good time to use it health-wise, but not so great fight progression-wise. this is going to be bad, I think. This is one of those bosses where I totally could have had her on my first try. I kind of got stuck on a pillar when I was dodging away from her. She only had a couple hits left. Could have gotten healing. I don't know if she's going to be full-on Smelter Demon bad. We've gotten pretty close. Move set's pretty tight and easy to predict. It's those right there, though, right? Because now I'm trying to conserve Estus flasks for the second phase rather than just healing whenever I take enough damage to be in range of dying. It's probably going to be bad for me in the long run. Standing next to her butt for a while is where it's at, depending on what attack she's using now. I got a stagger off there. Couldn't tell if that's what that animation was. Love that effect of her burning the stuff around her when she attacks it. In the win. This is more like my first attempt here, because I'm going to do something really stupid soon, right? That. I don't know what happens every time she does that. Sometimes she does it more than once. I'm not going to risk it. We're going to top off here. Thank you. probably do the same now to top off, you know? Maybe not. Maybe that was a bad decision. Shit. It's the one I know I can punish and I'm smart about it. Because that doesn't matter. Excellent fight. Took me about 6 more attempts than I needed to. 2 of those didn't really count though when I was talking with Andrea. Take you. Cool. So we did go level up real quick. She's one of those bosses that... There's a good mix of bosses in this game that reward a pretty aggressive playstyle, I feel like. Her and Pontiff, both of them. Like, you should probably attack... If you think that it's safe to attack one time, you should probably attack her 3 or 4 times to save. Very well, then, Haken. Alright. Finish Vigor. Do Vitality for a while. I wanted to do some miracles, but you get vitality to 20 and then I'll start looking at faith and attunement. So that's 30 through 2. Farewell, Ashen One. Oh, she was the boss of the demo? That's cool. I didn't even know there was a demo in this game. So it just started you out having enough stats to deal with her? So we scaled her or something?
How?
I think I need Ashes to
get it.
Look at her soul description here. Thanks, Polar. You follow on that. The Dancer. One of the twisted souls steeped in strength, used to acquire many souls, or transposed to extract its true strength. The Pontiff Sullivan bestowed a double slashing sword upon a distant daughter of the former royal family, ordering her to serve first as a dancer and then as an outrider knight. They put her into exile. Cool. I think I still need to place one of these ashes too, huh? And then, well, we already have Aldrich. It's the room which shows. Alright. Soul of the Dancer, Soothing Sunlight. Okay, so that's the. It looks like it just says restores a large amount of HP instead of being a regen. Miracles of Guinevere. Okay, bring that back again. Dancer. Dancer's Enchanted Swords. Paired Enchanted Swords with Pontiff Sullivan. Bestowed upon the Dancer of the Boreal Valley. These blades, symbolic of the Dancer's vows, are enchanted by dark magic in the right hand and fire in the left, mirroring the Pontiff. Use the fury of both blades in a dancing spin motion and use strong attack to continue the performance until stamina's exhausted. That's pretty cool. I think I looked at the Yorm the Giant stuff. So Lord Yorm missed everything and fought unflinchingly as a one-man vanguard, following the loss of the one he was to protect and forsook his shield. Great machine. Yeah. Once lumbered on the front lines with a great shield, but one day in place of a shield, the left hand notch was added to his machete. And then the smashing technique could be a legacy of his. Oh, hey, Polar. Yeah, Andrea was talking to me about it. You're Nick, right? Oh, thanks for the follow. Welcome. I was thinking about putting an ad for the Twitch channel up at the local theater in town. Yeah, she was, Andrea called me today, she met with Elizabeth, she sent me a link about Earthbound and Undertale, because you know, Earthbound's my favorite game. I'm like, oh my god, are we friends now? That's really cool, welcome. Looking forward to meeting you officially this Saturday. I like how the giant's chair there is bigger, that's pretty awesome. Yeah, we got some systems going on here. You can vote for the next game we're going to play if you go to vote.marsa.com. There's a bunch of titles on there. And you can look at what we've beaten so far at games.marsa.com. Huzzah! We'll have to do some, there's like a board game night that they do out here in Los Alamos, so we'll have to hang out. That'll be fun. I had that feeling when Andrew and I were in California, I'm a stay-at-home husband there, right? And you'd think that there would be a lot of like nerdy gamers in California, but everybody was too busy. They kind of had this attitude of, oh, I used to play games, but not anymore. All right, let's go, let's get dangerous. I think we can progress if we put down that base and then retreat to the boss fight. Not sure. I'll ask chat to help me out as usual. If I'm approaching the point of no return to end the game, give me a heads up. I think I'm pretty far from that, but you know, if I'm about to go through a fog door that would end the game, let me know. I do want to play the DLC for this when it comes out. Try to figure out some solution with that. Oh, that's cool. Nice, because the other statues in this room are all holding their heads. Oh man, I'm pretty jealous. I'm really looking forward to when Andrew and I have kids. What is the optimal way to introduce your kid to gaming, you know? I think it can be done, and I think you can introduce them to games in a way that has them appreciate older titles. It'll be tough, but I think it can be done. Hey, Namaku, it's Groovin. How's your Wednesday treating you? Let's see if I can fix this. I got this weird PS4 dashboard issue. Okay, just fix it. Google didn't. It's apparently a known issue. Cool. Give it up. Visions of armor. No tough enemy ahead. You don't deserve this. Monster ahead. Time for Bloodstain. Doesn't have to be a shortcut. Cool. How is Elite Dangerous? I've heard it's pretty cool. When I hear a roar like that on a bridge, I assume the dragon's gonna come eat me from previous Souls games. Maybe we're okay. I know it's part of several like big space sims that are trying to accomplish that realistic space sim fantasy like Star Citizen. Yeah. You got foreign language skills out of it? That's really cool, sir. Yeah, I think I built my vocabulary pretty significantly playing video games. Oh shit. No! So worried that roar from before is gonna bite me in the butt if I'm not cognizant of my environment. That'd be fun to have you actually just fight a knight and then the dragon shows up partway through if you take too long. Oh shit, I'm stuck in the wall here. No! Oh, this guy's got poise for days. Enemies get poise, but I don't know about it. Those things explode, right? Yeah, they sure do. Die against this guy. I've totally fought these guys before and been fine. Not today. Building vocabulary definitely helped me a lot. I've said before, like, when you're reading a book, there's a word you don't understand, you can often get away with skipping it. But if there's a word you don't understand in a video game, you need to understand it often to progress the story. So I think games are great for just about every kind of learning. Oh, no worries. Is the title of the game, it's coming from your different ratings, right? Like you've got like a trade rating and like a piracy or danger rating. Where dangerous comes from. There we go. Ah, that was about 4 Estus flasks more trouble than I should have had with that guy. Remembering how to play the game, apparently. try planned encounter. It's a helpful clue. You've learned ellipses from Squall. Was there a thing I could have jumped off onto then? Go back up into the looking system. Holy shit. Whoa, okay, and the floor is poison. No, let's sneak back up here. Yeah, I think we're getting that with Minecraft as well. Consumed King's Garden. There's a couple different ways I could have gone here, so there might be another path back by the bonfire I want to check out. Rest Assured. Yeah, and I think that you can play tabletop RPGs with a kid when they're really, really young, right? Like, you pretty much just ask them to describe what their character does, and it's your job as the GM to be the referee. If you guys ever want to play tabletop, that's my jam. Fun to have a group out here in the Salmers. / Santa Fe. Alright, that guy's gnarly looking. I don't want to mess with him just yet. Ah, very good. The defects. The spoils. Boy. There's multiple versions of those guys. They haven't really explained what's up with that. I have a feeling it has something to do with humanity, you know? Humanity is described as being dark. Manus. Dark Souls 1. There we go. Man, that last guy we fought. Later, man. Good luck with Dark Souls as well. Cathedral Knight. I kind of want to read that item description, but I feel like I'm not in the safest spot to read shit right now with all these gnarly dudes walking about. Will I ever know it by fighting them? Like, will they ever drop an item that belies their name? Summon sign. I think there's a boss fight already over here. Yeah. I think that if you don't speak English, since so many video games come out in English, that would be a good vehicle to learn. Because same thing, like, separate from reading a book, you often need to understand some of the words to be able to progress in the story. I have a feeling there's going to be a boss fight in that room. Okay, I'll wait until I find it then. It's always fun for me. Let there be bravery. Oh, what's that sound? Help me. Friendship? I only have 4 Estus Flasks, so this is a fact-finding mission. Gotta learn Albed. Oh, what the hell is this thing?
You ignorant slaves.
It's not... Can't be taken
notice, have you?
The bosses almost never talk in this game.
Beloved Ocelot, child of dragons.
Ooh.
Well, I will not give him up. For he is all that I have.
Looks like Seath. I don't know if that's what they're trying to refer back to. Seath should be long dead though. Cool. It's a good use of their very rare. Seros, the Consumed King. It's a dragon man with a staff. Like I said, I only have the 4 Estus Flasks, so this isn't going to be my real attempts. I might even homeward bone out of here soon. It looks like he's injured in his stomach there. Talks during the fight, too. That's cool.
Come out.
Don't be afraid. You think I fight him? Probably cut his tail off, right? It's pretty common in these games. Okay. I think I'm gonna I'm gonna flee. I'm gonna come back with more Estus flasks. Cool. Seems like a fight that's definitely gonna have a second enemy in it, right? He's calling for his baby. Baby rage battle. I did get an additional Titanite chunk, but I need one more. Yeah, one more to upgrade my spear another step. So the reason for coming here would be able to get another Estus flask. Let's do that.
Ah, tis good, wasn't he?
Alright, other more different Ocelot. We might do Metal Gear Solid as the next game series we focus on after Dark Souls. Maybe I should just keep saying that forever, right? So we need 15,000 souls and some change. 16,000. I want to play it safe. So we might be able to do three... and all this other junk might cover it. Actually, I want my level up here. Heart's Desire is for another point of vigor. Oops. Oh, Vitality, actually. I didn't need to cash in all those other ones, but that's okay. Vit 14. And now we're going to try a salty run back to that dragon boss again. I think I know how to get there. I probably won't play the NES version, but I would play the MSX games, Metal Gear 1 and 2 for the MSX. So I think that the NES Metal Gear is like a... it's an attempted remake or port of the MSX version, so it doesn't have all the features. I've never beaten Metal Gear 1 or 2. I've only ever played the Solid series, so that would be the first. Alright, let's give this a stab. Alright, so this is the way I didn't go before. There's definitely something in there that is otherwise a dead end. So maybe I'll check this out and then head back to the bonfire if things don't turn out well for me. Oh, another red eye knight. Cool. What's up with the guy with the... oh shit. Probably not good things, right? It's probably very bad. That's very bad. Fairly objectively. Here, buddy. I'll just run in and grab it if I didn't use. Ooh, dude, this guy hits like a truck, man. Alright, maybe we'll bail out on this for now. I'll try to run in there and grab that item. And then run out. Fight them later, maybe. But I want to keep my enkindled form for the dragon boss fight. Oh, just a soul. There is another way out of here, it looks like. Hey Phoenix, what's grooving? How is Day of Odin treating you so far? I think the fun thing about Metal Gear 1 and 2 is that you can see Hideo Kojima's ideas were there really, really early. Like, he wasn't waiting for PS1 to do some of that stuff. Like if I recall correctly, I think in Metal Gear 1 you can walk around in a box to avoid enemies. It's pretty awesome. Alright, so Numbnuts is still out here, and I don't think I sent the elevator back down, so... wait, maybe I did. I like rolled off the ledge last time, and that was correct. Oh, interesting. So it appears you have to roll off the ledge, unless there's another way to get here. It's possible, possible. I should have followed it the rest of the way down and sent it back down with me. Don't know if there's actually anything over here. Oh, well, not gonna find out today. When I do MGS1, I might do. There's Titanite chunk. Man. Tempted to go upgrade my spear right now. The more tools for the boss fight, the better, you know? think I'll live without it for now. When we die, we'll definitely do it. That's exciting. It's interesting that he's got these knights guarding him, right? That's probably implying something. This is what I was saying though, I really like that in this game, like you see the cutscene the first time you go in, when you come back you just start fighting him, right? It doesn't look like I can directly target his tail, so if you want to cut his tail off, you probably have to stand behind him and make that happen. I don't know what that does, but it's probably not good for my health to be hit by it. This guy really lets you Ganondorf roll between his legs. Dodge here. Yeah, dodge! No! Come here, buddy. Come on. I like how this guy, some really well done, what are you doing, dude? Oh, he dropped his spear and now he's mastered phase two. And the music changed, awesome. Okay. Phase one is kind of a gimme. Oh my god, he goes crazy in phase two, it's awesome. That's a Seath thing. I think we're meant to be reminded of Seath from the start. Shit. That first phase, his tells are really well done, right? Can't use a Ember in this fight, unfortunately. Ouch, shit. Man, I'm not jicking around. That living a dream there, getting a stagger. Don't want to stand in that, I assume. Yeah. Whew. Gotta dodge. Gotta dodge. Ah! Yeah, this is a very Bloodborne-like boss. I agree. Oh, it is curse. So it is Seath in the first game. Rage crying in the background. Probably should do another heal just to be safe here, given he's going so quickly on me. Shit. You get his tail sometimes if you're lucky. Got a mild but not complete stagger there. Hey, Flare Wayne. Shit. Been a good time to attack him if I had got a dodge off. Oh. I got punished pretty hard there by him being pretty aggressive. Nice. Sorry, I just saw your message, Polarbrewski. If you've never played a Metal Gear Solid game, what should you start with? I would not start with 5, I don't think. Let me think about that. That's a tough question. All right, we're gonna go upgrade our spear. Help just a little bit. I would start with Metal Gear Solid 1 and I would play the GameCube remake of it, which if you don't have a GameCube, you should be able to pick it up. It's called The Twin Snakes. You probably play it on Dolphin. The reason for that is that the PS1 game is a really good start. It gets you into the series, but it's a PS1 game, so as with most PS1 games, it hasn't aged terribly well. So you can get around that by playing the remake, which looks quite good and is the same game. But I think that playing through them in release order is pretty critical just because of the way that Hideo Kojima, the creator, approaches storytelling. I remember being really hesitant to get into Metal Gear when I first heard about it when I was younger because I didn't really care for stealth, you know, or like political intrigue. But those games are very far from that. Like, there is stealth and there is political intrigue, but the developer is such a quirky Japanese guy. To give you an example and not spoil a ton of fights, there's a fight in the first Metal Gear Solid game where you're going up against a psychic. And the way he proves to you that he's a psychic is that he reads your memory card and tells you what kind of games you like. And he, like, tells you to put your controller on the floor, and then he makes it move with his mind by making it vibrate. And while you're fighting him, he dodges all of your shots automatically. Like, he can always get away from you as long as you have the controller plugged into the first port. But if you unplug the controller from the first port and plug it into the second port, he can't read your mind anymore and you can beat him. So that's kind of my just describing the Psycho Mantis fight is how I would get someone interested in the Metal Gear Solid series, because Hideo Kojima does shit like that all the time, and it's awesome. So interested in breaking the fourth wall. Oh, I'm stoked for doing Castlevania on stream. I'm trying to decide now if I want to make Castlevania my next 24-hour stream, or if I'm going to have to kill this guy. Try sending him to the elevator first. Assume he follows me in here. Did he just walk off the ledge? I think he just walked off the ledge! Awesome, yeah, they're the souls. That was fantastic. Yeah, so I haven't decided yet if I want to do Castlevania as my next franchise focus or do that as my next 24-hour stream. They're both pretty good, I think. Go. Try this again. Last attempt was really, really good. Kind of got overwhelmed at the end. Chased by him. Expect him to be riding up the elevator. Yeah. Yeah, and they're very playable. There's different play styles you can go at it. It feels like in Metal Gear, generally, that stealth is a style choice. Like, you could play through the games without ever stealthing. You'd have a harder time depending on what difficulty you play on, but... And I think that while Metal Gear Solid 3 is the first one, like, chronologically in the story, it works best as a prequel. You know, come at it later on in the story. Alright, let's start off all pissed. I might start the Mass Effect series over. I played it pretty early in the stream, so the whole viewers make decisions didn't work out so great. What I don't know is if he goes to second form based on time in the fight or based on health percentage reached. Holy shit. I did not let that happen. That would have been a good time to use an Ember, but I want to wait until I'm in phase 2 before I do that, I think. Punish too if I got the dodge off in time. Completing my age-old tradition of doing really well on the first attempt and screwing up after that. I think the pattern with bosses that do that to me is that I tend to have that happen in bosses that have a second phase of the smelter room.
Awesome.
stab him in the butt a little bit there. Shit. Full panic spin. Probably not the best decision. Ow. Also not great. Oh, shit. Oh, well, if you like stealth, then you should definitely play them. Yeah. I didn't realize that I liked stealth games until I played games that were built around stealth, right? Most of my experience with stealth as a young gamer were games that weren't stealth games that had a stealth level that forced you to play differently from the rest of it, and often there wasn't as much attention to detail. But when a game like Metal Gear Solid is built from the ground up, is emphasizing stealth, I think it works really well. Yeah, that's why it's giving me so much trouble, Serp, since they all have multiple phases. Can I get him to do what he did last time? That would be really swell. You want to just walk in the pit again? Oh, he's actually on the elevator now. He wasn't far enough down for it to have killed him. Is this the quickest way for me to run back to this boss, by the way, or is there like a closer bonfire or checkpoint or something? I feel like this is about the length of a typical boss run, but if there's a shorter path, it'd be helpful to know. Yeah, MGS3 is amazing. It's my favorite game in the whole series. This is the fastest route. Okay, thank you. Wasting Estus Flask right at the start of this fight. I'll see if I can take a hit from him first before I heal. Famous last word of Jared. That. Not quite like that. Maybe a little bit better, not die after two hits. Alright, so that fight ended when I said, I'll wait to Estus Flask until he gets a hit off on me. I was already dead when I said that, so I think I should go in and get the full heal. Yeah, I think that baiting the second phase, trying to rush into it, is one of my problems, and the other problem now is with the having the Ember up. It gives you so much more leeway to make mistakes in the first phase, and I keep refusing to use it until the second phase, so I have so many fewer hit points. Yeah, I didn't have invincibility frames there. How you doing, Retro? If I can get him to follow me in before it makes all the way up here. Yeah, I don't know what drives this guy's movement decisions. He's kind of all over the place. Oh shit. Bad timing, buddy. I mean, good timing for you. Could try riding it the rest of the way down. He got off the ledge that time. Oh, this boss is really hard for people running on SL1. Interesting. So I can kind of get through here without taking any falling damage. Oh, good to hear it. I'm sorry you were sick earlier. Does this always take damage? Oh, well, if it does, if I do that, shit. Running, running, running. Alright, so down two Estus Flask for this attempt. That's okay. Worst things have happened. Oh man, Aki Fall Retro, your birthdays are coming up this week?
Cool.
Yeah, I have to go all the way down. I guess I could do that next time. The run back up easier. This guy's really good at running away from me. Oh, I thought I was gonna avoid that. It's not. Shit. Pressed the wrong button there. Phase two. Gotta get behind him when he goes to phase two. Semi-take damage will be a good time to use the Ember, I think. Shit. Like now, but I gotta get away from him first. Double shit. Triple shit. Get away! Now that move, I'd love to be able to reliably get some damage off on him. Maybe I can do it if I have him in a corner, right? Have him charge me into a corner instead? Like that? Funny, because you almost never want to put yourself against a wall in boss fights in this game. This guy feels like kind of an exception, even though you are. And we got a stagger off there. Get out! Get out! Whew! I was hoping for the stagger there. There are baby sounds in that fight. What is settings? I see that Sarnas. Soul of Consumed Saves. Let's see if we're gonna run into the Ocelot thing later. The Consumed King, one of the twisted souls steeped in strength. Okay. Used to acquire their souls. His heroes went mad trying to harness his royal blood for a greater purpose, leading him to the heretics of the Grand Archives, where he discovered the twisted worship of Seath the Paledrake. Oh man, more Dark Souls 1 stuff. This game is so awesome. I love the Souls series. It's the best. I'm gonna go home and level up Souls for the boss fight. A bunch of areas that I haven't explored out here too, so different paths that I can come back to later. Yeah, the dragon guy we were fighting was mourning for his child. He was like trying to continue the pale dragon bloodline. I don't know if he himself was always a pale dragon. He used to just be like a regular dude. Alright, so we're gonna keep him vitality up to 20. Perfect.
Farewell, Ashen One.
Let's see if that enables me to use any new gear. I kind of wanted to have like a torch as a backup. Awesome. So now I can dynamically switch between my shield and my torch if I run into leech enemies again. How about the bow? Can I dynamically switch between that yet? No. Well, it's a particularly heavy bow. Maybe if I decide to upgrade the original longbow instead, it might be a better decision. What's up, dog? Let's see if we can get some more story here. Moonlight Greatsword consumed Osiris. Interesting. Legendary dragon weapon associated with Seath the Pildrake. Charge strong attack to its limit to unleash Moonlight Wave. Osiris, the Consumed King, was infatuated with the search for Moonlight, but in the end, it never lived up to him. So the Moonlight Greatsword has been in every Souls game so far, even in Bloodborne. Just otherwise pretty different. White Dragon Breath. Its crystal breath, piercing quality, Seath's research seems to strike a chord with Old Big Hat, who in his mad disrobe state made divine work such as this his own. Osiris was no doubt edified by this. Cool. So I'd probably get the Moonlight Greatsword. I won't use this playthrough. Oh, really? The Moonlight Greatsword was actually an armored core as well? So it's a From Software thing. I just kind of want to see how many... How many Titanite chunks do I need now? 6, yes. Well, that's going to take a minute. Let me see, if I take out my regular longbow, how much that weighs. If it's somewhere... Oh, it goes all the way back to Kingsfield. Holy crap, so further back than I even thought. Because this game is, the Souls series was, Miyazaki, did he work on Kingsfield, or did he just like it and wanted to make his version of it? Oh, it's under a different code. I think I'm blind? Yes, but... Oh, and the Dragon Seath was in that game. Okay, so even now the bow's a little too heavy, but I'll hold on to it for until I get my vitality up to the point where I can hold both of them. Use it in your first playthrough? Cool. Joke weapons. Yeah, right, so you can embarrass somebody in PvP? Probably. I think it's tough because I don't think there are any weapons that are, like, intentionally bad, if that makes sense. There are weapons that are silly, like the pizza cutter from Bloodborne, but it's pretty good if you use it well. Cane mane for days. Alright, can I open this door? Indeed I can. I'm still tempted to check out the other stuff. I wonder if they're going to take us to an archives like this that was in Dark Souls 1. Aww. So this is one of the pilgrim people, but this one doesn't have a turtle knapsack. Are we going to find the asshole who murdered our friend back in town? Oh, they might be bad guys in here. They are, in fact, bad guys in here. Easier to deal with, though. Thanks. They were dying against that thing I was just fighting? Must have been. Half of the dragon. Oh, I think I know where to use that. Yes, is it another mimic? That actually isn't a mimic for once. Where was that dragon? Like, what's the nearest bonfire for the dragon that was down in the depths? I remember what it looked like and generally where it is, but I don't remember which bonfire was closest to it. It was in the area with all the jailers, wasn't it? Illusion ahead. No monster ahead. Good looking out message. I really like this aspect of the game with other players giving tips. was an illusion. Nice. No illusory wall. Irithyll Dungeon is the one I want. Okay. Is that a covenant, maybe? Hey, time to split. Thanks for the host. How have you been, my friend? Nice. Contra 3. What's your experience with Contra 3? Are you so good in practice with it that you can play it without using the code? I don't think I've ever beaten it without the code. It is, in fact, a heart rate. Pick one up. It's pretty cool. Gets pretty high during Souls boss fights. I'm very concerned. Doesn't this look like an area that we've been in before? Like the very first area of the game, except now it's shrouded in darkness? I don't think that's the implication here, is it? Oh, maybe it might be. At least it's part of this area. Oh, this is the Japanese version of Infinite Continues? Gotcha. Yeah. No, you'd have to play a lot of that game. You pretty much just have to memorize it to be able to play it. Well, that's cool. I probably should have gone and fought them when I had a free kill in, huh? Oh, goodness gracious. Great Balls of Fire. Okay, alright. Everything's fine, everything's good. Yeah, my resting heart rate is about 70 beats per minute. Whenever I go live with any game, just like additional alertness of streaming goes up to about 90 to 100 is resting, and then boss fights and difficult content tend to make it go pretty high. Ashen Estus Ruin. Okay, so it's the Flower Points version of the Estus Flask Ring. Hey Frappuccino, how you been? And you know, I'm thinking about doing some more Mario Maker once we finish fighting all the bosses in, Oh, more dogs. Fantastic. Best enemy. I thought if one died in one hit, that they would both die in one hit. I was incorrect. Probably get murdered in this corner here. Oops. So I haven't played Mario Maker levels in a while, but there's been enough time for the show levels. Shit. There we go. Live in the dream. Ooh, and they dropped Titanite chunks. Oh, that's super exciting. Does anyone in chat know how often they drop those chunks? Like, is it worth farming for it? So I gotta equip an item to make that farming easier. So they get to avoid getting staggered on the second swing, which is weird. Maybe the amount of like stagger points I'm dealing is there's like a stagger and a half or something like that. Shit. Ooh, I'm getting summoned. Let's go this way. Okay, looks like it's not the only thing they drop. They also drop a large Titanite shard. So this is me being called to defend another player of Dark Souls that just got invaded by an unfriendly player. Probably not worth farming right now. Gotcha. Median Battle.net here. That pretty much permeates their system. Hopefully they'll add an offline mode finally. So red guy is the bad guy. Other dude over here, help. I don't know why he stopped fighting at the end there, but, you know, I'll do my thing. Okay, Maybe he just saw that there were two people and he's like, no. Yeah, there is Warcraft Adventure, Lord of the Clans, and there was Starcraft Ghost, right? There were two properties that they started on and then abandoned. Okay. Back to business. Health. To be nice? In what way, Flaring? Oh, really? That's kind of cool, then. But I'm not Dark Moon yet, so... do I have the tools necessary to do the Dark Moon thing? I remember where that NPC is, but I didn't think I had the right item to interact with her yet at the time when I first met her. Bullshit. Around this corner. That's messed up From Software dog placement right there. Lure you with an item and have something right around the corner. So many chumps. I need three more to upgrade my spear to its penultimate state. Very exciting. You can get summoned without being enkindled, right? Or is that not true? Pull back. Probably not good that I'm not listening, right? Now, there's two giant crystal lizards out here. Can I fight them independently? Ouch. Looks like I can, which is good. There's the stagger. Nice. I do? Okay. I'm gonna go back to her next time I get to a bonfire. Ouch. Come here. Come on. Go all roly poly on me, that's totally cool. I'm judging. Staggered, right? And maybe it wore off. There we go. Nice. All the skills. I have the ability to do what is needed, but I don't have the tools. Well, I don't know. Like, assuming what I have to do is in Anor Londo, I don't know if I want to spend a ton of time just wandering around there, because I don't know where I have and haven't been. Can you tell me generally what I have to do to find it to progress? I do think this is the same as the bonfire from the beginning of the game. I wonder if something changed now that everything's dark. Like we saw there was the eclipse of the sun earlier. Praise it all day, but... I wonder if everything out here is dark now. You've defeated the Lords of Cinder. Learn a gesture from NPC. Mm-hmm. Oh, hello. Shit. Smart. I don't know what that does, but it's probably not good for me. It's like a meteor attack. Didn't that kill her? Oh, hello. Did. Fantastic. Falling damage for the win. Yeah. These guys count as hollows, so they're giving back flat seasons? They can give back flat seasons? There it is. Ouch. So there's a mage dude down there. Shit. Get out of dodge. I see you, baby. Hey, what does this say? Friendship required ahead, but huh, it's an artisan. Yeah, this is where I fought the first boss of the game, Iodex. Visions of Revenge. Ha 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 ha! Nice. Round two. Not really ready for this fight. I got all these souls in my hands. Ouch. I do want to attempt him with full blast this time, you know? Shit, man. I gotta stop that from happening. That happened to me a couple times so far where accidentally use shit. Ouch. Kick when I mean to attack. Don't think it's gonna stay that way. Propagable if the first fight against this dude is any indication. Just curious what this is yet. Black Knight. Oh. Ooh. He literally throws you across the room. Outstanding. I think we're gonna wanna bone out of here. Try it again in a second. Spend these souls, I'm gonna lose 40,000 souls. Ito. Yeah, so do you have any idea where that NPC is, the gesture that I have to learn? Because I'd be down to try to do that. If I wanted to level up twice, I would need 18,000 souls. Let me just go first. Very well taken. Farewell, Ashen One. Right, so now I need 18 and some change, almost 19. So if I wanted to do that, for a summon sign, I can boost you with it? Really? Okay, check that out in a second. Farewell, Ashen. Probably still can't afford to also have a bow equipped, right? We're getting there, much closer. So I think that when we get Vit to 20, which is when I plan to stop, we'll be able to have all the things equipped that I want to have equipped. This bridge, right? Do I actually have to summon them like an ally, or is the summon sign gonna like make an NPC appear? That's unusual for the series. Poor doggos. This is the bridge you're talking about, right? Maybe I'm SOL. It's too bad. Dark Moon is my favorite covenant in Dark Souls 1. Untended Graves is the evil version of Cemetery Garage. What was the gesture called? Just make sure I didn't, like, get it and dismiss it too quickly. After the dragon, toast, sleep, stretch out, collapse, rest, bow, call over. Alright, we're gonna try doing a salty run back here to Champion Gundyr. Might not go so hot because there's some nasty, nasty enemies out here. Give it a try all the same. Have to learn the route anyway. Dark Moon Loyalty, right. The hollows up here are still as weak as they were before. Round two. No free damage this time. I'm not standing right next to him when he gets started. Okay, maybe going ultra aggressive is not the way to go with this dude. I don't actually remember his moveset and how similar it is to what it was before. Oh yeah, another step I need to do? Okay, feel free to let me know. Ouch. Of the deep, so I assume those red eyes mean. He doesn't have a gross humanity thing this time, though, so I don't know what causes that to happen or not happen. Get away as soon as you can. Baron Keep, Large Wall, Ladder. Ouch. Bad decision. Just trying to top myself off since I was doing pretty well. Interesting. Soul of Champion. Once a champion came late to the festivities and was greeted by a shrine without fire and a bell that would not toll. Interesting. I wonder where they're going with that. Yeah, I don't know if that's what they're going for with a cat. It was a really cool boss fight, though. Victory. Now the real fight begins. Fine arc. Yeah, I love attack animations in that fight. So this, it's like I'm looping back to the Firelink Shrine, but in like a dark alternate reality. I think this is technically alternate, but I think I can still go back to the original area where I fought. Right? Let me try to do this thing about going to Farron Keep. So Farron Keep here. Look for a large wall with a ladder. Explore from there. Okay. And this is the right bonfire to start from? The one that just says Farron Keep, I assume? It should be a little bit easier for me to look around and progress here than last time. I'm a bit higher level. And is it like inside of Farenkeep? Or is it outside somewhere? I'm gonna be approaching a really big wall from the outside that has a ladder next to it. Or am I gonna immediately backtrack and go up this ladder here? The outer perimeter of this area here. Okay. That guy was a humanoid armor man. When we fought him originally, if you go back and watch the Dark Souls 3 Part 1 VOD, he turned into a nasty shadow demon man. His moves are too smooth. Oh, you know, I think I remember seeing a ladder somewhere along this path. There's a bunch of other nonsense out here, right? I want to say that there's basilisks out here somewhere. Yeah, that's correct. There's one. You can't roll, unfortunately. Hopefully they die a bit faster than when I first met them. Gross. Looking for a ladder. Shit, that could be bad for me. Get out of the petrify juice. Looking for a really big ladder somewhere. I do think I remember seeing one and then not climbing, but like having something else going on in the swamp and then forgetting to come back and check it out later. It's not that way. Try over here. Yeah, my kingdom for like, what was it, the rusted iron ring in Dark Souls 1 once you move through sludge like this a little bit faster. A little bit faster if I spam roll, but I'm not sure. I see any ladders there. I might be able to climb up these rocks and take a look here in a second. If I'm going in absolutely the wrong way, feel free to tell me as well. There's a lot of shenanigans out here. Back to the big wall. And this might have been when I backed out. Oh wait, there's a new item that's promising. Shit. Don't get petrified, that would be bad. Try not to get petrified, dude. Get out of that. There we go. Somewhere along the wall. Okay. I'm dealing with the enemies that would get in my way otherwise, so. Oh, I never came back here. Crystal's room? No trap ahead, therefore try chest. Golden scroll. The giant square thing I was looking at? How's that thing doing? Interesting. I kinda wanna read what's going on in this room, right? Find something. Golden scroll. Given to a sorcerer to learn the arts of Ulaseel. Ooh, sorcerer's actually love such shiny things. So you think that's what they're getting at in here? That's the story of this section. It was antiquated, right? Labyrinth board, ivory colored silvers, and beauty of ancient magic power, no protections offered by the garment that was never intended for battle. I think that's actually that's the gear that the lady from Ulaseel in Dark Souls 1, the DLC is wearing, isn't it? I gotta get her name. So we're thinking it's this big square building here, spiky. I'll try to walk around and see if we can find a ladder somewhere. I What other bullshit? Things in the trees. I don't know if they like drop down on me or something. Hello! Fat baby. The big nasty bloodborne lizard guys. So the Keep Ruins bonfire. Nameless armor. Oh, is that knight armor? I won't use it this time, but that was my favorite armor set. I wonder why they added Nameless on top of it. Maybe a little bit more, favor. So we're thinking I actually went the wrong way. Oh, the VOD didn't go through, unfortunately. I forgot to hit start recording when I started it. It is, if you go to the games.marsa.com, and you go to free play or other videos or something like that, there should be a link to the 2016 VOD archive, and you should be able to find it there. It's just part of a huge VOD with every other game we played that day, but I don't have a standalone VOD for it. I might be able to download it from YouTube later. No, I tried to save it. Alright, so this is the wall that Flareon was talking about. We'll keep trying to follow along this path and see if we find it. I'm getting close to it or I miss it, let me know. Yeah, so this is the big door that we opened by busting up everything else in this area, right? So it must be somewhere else in here that we haven't found yet. And it's like a castle wall, so over here must be the wrong way, right? Unless it's over by the crab. This is also a castle wall, so please do some more. So, behind where we fought this, we found this crab guy here. This crab is going a lot faster than all this weapon appearance. Oh man, that thing dropped something, but I didn't get a chance to see what it was. Was there anything important you guys know? Like a gem or a spell or something? Wow, look at this really flavorful single white tree. It doesn't have a bunch of those branches that make you go invisible. Enders are cool. Yeah. Crown of Dusk. I don't think we found any headgear that has a unique effect yet. Feather crown bestowed upon a princess of Ulda Seal, land of ancient golden sorcerers. Guardian of Elizabeth's blessings, this raises the power and effect of the wearer's magic, but damage suffered by magic attacks rises in tandem. Okay. I'll just follow this wall. I can only run over to the opposite side if I don't find it. Go progressive and that's what the boss we just fought. I'm just curious if that was going to. Oh no! Aww. Is this place like what's left of Ulda Seal or something? Not the mushroom people. Aww. Sage's scroll. I think that's Insertion of talent, insertion of fun, insertion of talent. That's a bummer. That's so cool too, just in a corner of the area out here. They're not going to explain it, it's just going to be a thing. Yeah. Poor mushroom people. What a bummer. Let's go fight the conclave of Vicar Amelia's over here. Well, I didn't realize he did that. I hope you did that lesson I told you these days. I never slew the mushrooms. Obviously we're in the Mushroom Kingdom. I saw somebody describe that. They're like, you know, what's something about a game that's technically true but doesn't seem like it should be? And they're like, in the Dark Souls 1 DLC, you go save a princess in the Mushroom Kingdom. These guys are lizards. Kind of look more like evil bipedal stags to me. Oh, that one's still alive? Oh shit. He was super dead. That was super dead. Ferris's hats. The name Ferris is said to have once belonged to a hero, but is now more widely known as a style of hat. There. Hey, look at this. We're running along the wall, not trudging through the swamp. Fantastic. I have a feeling trudging is about to start again soon. Howdy, gnarly, nasty goat. Ow. You die this thing. Oh, God, are you kidding me? 60,000 souls. And I have no idea where the hell that is. It's near a big fire on the ground somewhere. That was all hubris, too. I totally could have rolled away. I was like, no, this is a regular enemy. You know, I can just spam R1 and kill it eventually, right? That's how this game works. Congrats. Ugh, all right, let's go get the souls back. Let's see if there's a better way to get to them. I open the door full spray. Later. Happy laundrying. Might be a worthy item over in that direction. And I'm curious as if this gets us to the same place we need to be. Where I just left all my stuff behind. Poison weapon. Oh, are these the dark wraiths? It is. Okay. They're just one of them at a time. Don't eat my souls! Not that I have very many to lose right now. Yeah, I'm letting these early areas kick my ass. It drops the sword in a red eye orb, it's fun. Another one on the other side of that, isn't there? Sage's Coal. Oh, another kingdom. Yeah, no, I hear ya. Not as good of a use of tips in this game. Maybe they got some complaints or something. They wanted to make that a little bit clearer to understand. Yeah, lots of developer messages that kind of tell you directly what to do in the previous games make that a lot harder to figure out. So I might be passing the ladder right now, but I kind of want to get my souls back, so... No, apparently not. Hey, look at that. Revenge time. I can lock on successfully. Or I could die to him exactly the same way I just did and have him jump on my face a bunch. The other loot that's out here, down here. Titanite shard, so it might be along this wall. I don't think I've seen a ladder yet. Make sure that's not one over here. No, it's just a cracking wall. Running. Now we really, really don't want to die. It's also just a crack. Ladders do exist.
You can see them if you try. Ladders do exist.
You and I. Pretty historically bad at noticing ladders, though. I haven't already missed it, have I? I feel like this is really close to the bonfire. Maybe I just passed it on the other side. Wait. No, it's not ladder. This is where I got the other thing. This is just taking me back to the bonfire room, right? Alright. Well, I think I still want to run along this way because I don't have to trudge to the swamp and fight a bunch of basilisks. So. Well, speak up what it's near to if you see it. There's a specific element of the environment that stands out near it. I've been everywhere except where it is. Wouldn't surprise me. Oh, this is the... Oh, the Keep Ruins bonfire. Oh, yeah, earlier when you said starting from that bonfire, I thought you meant the one I was already at. Alright. I know where that one is. I can do that if I approach an enemy that I don't want to fight. It's around back here where we fought the stag guys, right? And they're still there. We try to not fight them. The guys that killed me. Oh, it's not on the outer perimeter. There's a spiky right that it's one of those like square buildings somewhere. Not super far from the Keep Ruins going for. It's not going to be through this gate, right? Huge building. I think this goes up to the Keep Ruins. Let me go home first and spend these souls, and we'll check again. Oh, this one's different. Okay. The slug gazebo? Okay, I think I remember where that was. Cool, I won't go spend souls just yet. This shouldn't be... In theory, this shouldn't be too difficult. Fingers crossed. Oh, yeah, I see what you're saying. Slug gazebo right there. It's not the slug gazebo, but it's this building, probably. Ah, there it is. Yay, it's teamwork. Thanks, everybody. And no worries. I got to find some items, and I found, like, the mushroom people, so it wasn't all awash. There's some cool flavor. A lot of Ulasil stuff down here. I don't know if the layout here is meant to be reminiscent of Ulasil. Also interested to know if the Boreal Valley and Anor Londo and all the other Dark Souls 1 stuff in this game maps back to Dark Souls 1, is like if things that are in both games exist the same distance from each other. Okay, I'm gonna find this. Oh, it's a big wolf. Cool. Old Wolf of Farron. Great Wolf. Watchdogs. Interesting. We have some proof of the Covenant there. Ancient Medallion depicting the crest of a wolf symbolizes the pact of the Old Wolf of Farron, equipped to pledge oneself to the Watchdogs. The Watchdogs ensure that the warrior is sleeping in serenity by taking the form of loyal spirits and hunting down those who would trespass the woods of Farron. Okay, so very similar to the Cat Covenant from Dark Souls 1, it sounds like. And the NPC I want to talk to should be somewhere up here, I assume. Sounds like. I heard a crystal wizard down there as well. Whoa! Oh, this game is so cool. Wait, is this an alternate path of progress? Holy shit. No? Oh, it's the asylum. It's like actually the asylum demon. Okay, well, give me a minute. Go back the other way. There's still a couple other directions I could explore here. Wow, it's so pretty. Oh, is that the whole swamp I was just in? Wow. Yeah, I'll check what's up there as well. But... we'll go up there after I've gone home and spent my souls and that kind of thing. I wonder if it's one of those, it's up in here or something. Nope, wait. Not quite bottomless pit, but probably still counts as a bottomless pit. Ah. Oh, I see. That's, if that's a hidden door, then that's a really, that's a good way to do it, right? Because you can see it from the inside. You know where to look. I'll put a message here. Someone else may already have one, but... Dream Chaser's Ashes. Okay. So, some more loot. I think that the Crystal Wizard heard me. Oh, come on, man. It's gonna get away, isn't it? Yeah. Hey, look at that. Oh, interesting. That's cool. Yeah, I don't think I would have figured that out without y'all's help. I guess maybe I could have come here and found the ashes and traded them in normally and just seen her around in Firelink. So we'll do that. We'll level up a couple times. We'll talk to this NPC. We'll go get the Darkmoon Covenant, and then I will... I'll continue progressing from the Champion Gundyr Bonfire. That's fine. And is she talking while she was while I was leveling up there? I need the sound in my headphones. Okay, I think we got enough to carry the bow with us now. Black Bow of Ferris. Oh yeah. Wasn't this in Dark Souls 1 as well? Well, that's even less heavy. What do you think upgrades it? If it's Twinkling Titanite, then I'm all day on board. I'll double check the equipment rules for it as well. 18 and 9.
That is what needs.
Soul of the Mind, Kegel. Did she actually start to say that?
One of the crystals, I suppose you should know. This cold, hardly a surprise, is it?
Cool. All right. What's it for you?
Ah. Ashen one, what this barren dust, stuff of a fool, won't yield aught. Where didst thou happen upon the stuff? Tell me for the sport.
Interesting.
Oh yes, I see. Clinging to lofty dreams in this dying world, more's the pity.
That's a great thing to find behind the mystery wall.
One most foolish indeed.
Huh.
Wouldst thou not agree?
Interesting. I wonder where they're going with that. Any of that? Any of that? Ooh, with the dancer gear. It would be pretty cool looking. Turn the dancer into a beast adventure. Oh, there's the big hat. Big hat Logan.
Ashen one.
Yeah, the feel of Dark Souls is pretty close to Castlevania. It's a little bit more serious. I don't know. The Belmont family, they're kind of superheroes, and the protagonists of the Dark Souls games don't really feel like superheroes. It feels like they're winning through their curse of immortality, that they can't die, so just through sheer force of will and trying something over and over, they eventually prevail. Do they have any additional effects on them, or do they just look cool, flaring? Dancer's legs as you skip like that. That's funny. Alright, we just did that to reload Firelink. It seemed like her weakest point during that fight. Stab her in the butt a whole bunch, right? Yeah, I think that there's a lot of stuff to sell about Dark Souls, and the atmosphere is really, really chief among them.
Hello again. I have since heard a great deal about you. For one, that you are most gentle of heart.
That's me.
I, too, am bound by duty, but can offer you my sign. I hear that cordial intrusion lays the path to embers. If I can be of help, by all means, do call upon me.
So she'll show up as a summon sign later on. Gotcha.
If you should require assistance, use my sign, Blessing of the Moon.
Blessing of the Moon upon your journey. So Gwyndolin from Dark Souls 1 was eaten. I think it's Prison Tower, yeah? Eaten by Aldrich, this like cannibal gang. He uses a meat puppet. Aldrich is just like a gross sludge on the ground. And the leader of the Covenant of the Dark Moon ended up passing to, like, Priscilla's descendant. Or at least she looks like Priscilla, and she has the tail under him. Pretty neat. I kind of like that they have... I feel like, for all the shit people give to Dark Souls 2, that, like, coming back to Anor Londo in this one wouldn't have all the weight that it does if 2 had been a direct sequel as well, you know? Oh, it's probably going to show up as an option when I talk to her. Right?
Thou think this town, I bid thee. Thou thinks too. Very well. Captain to this nightless company I remain. I will grant thee purpose. Thou's journeyed far. Hear my voice. If thou shalt swear by the Covenant to become a shadow of Father Gwyn and Sister Guinevere,
mm-hmm.
a blade that shall hunt the foes of our lords, then I place thee under the aegis and the power of the Dark Moon.
All about that. All about that. Base.
Thou art now a blade of the Dark Moon.
Oot.
The only knight of our company.
Cool.
Swear this oath and face thy solemn duty.
Oh, it's so cool.
Oh, if I can provide thee succor.
Okay, so proof of concord kept.
Also made...
Which I also get for being a blue sentinel. I see. I thought maybe there's a different token for being a blue sentinel. Read this guy here. A silver pendant between the Dark Moon and sword, the crest of the Dark Moon Knights, original Blue Sentinels. Ah, okay. Equipped to pledge himself to the Blade of the Dark Moon Covenant. That makes sense. Remember the way the Blue Phases are experienced, the Blades of the Dark Moon by ancient cord. Help to root out the invaders. Summoning takes place automatically when equipped. Nice.
Oh, if I...
Oh, I can offer multiple at once, thank god. Most of those, I think, are from...
Long ago, our father, Gwyn, lamenting the waning of the fire, became cinder of his own will. Now, the fire is linked by the champions who have come in his stead. Such is the will of Father and the gods. And so the Dark Moon Knights took arms to watch over those who link the fire. But long ago, our company lost its last proper knight. Only its covenant was preserved to this day, until the time of thy visit. Erdem taketh many forms, indeed.
Cool.
Also soon, may the Dark Moon watch...
May the Dark Moon watch over you. That's pretty cool, man. I am all day on board with that. Alright, let's go progress a little bit further from the Champion Gundyr Bonfire and see what we find. This series really is something else. If you haven't played the Souls series before, I recommend you get into it. It is difficult. I think that people like overemphasize its difficulty, but it's more, you have to have the patience to learn, like, Praise the Moon. It'll test your patience with boss fights, but you'll eventually get good at it. And I think it's fun that the biggest element of you getting good isn't your stats improving as a character, you leveling up, it's the fact that you as a player understand the mechanics better, you understand the bosses better, you understand the map layout better. And after you beat the game, if you immediately make a new game with a different character, you will go through it much, much, much faster. Now, is it a Black Knight? Or a Silver Knight? I'm not sure. I'm not sure I'm sneaking up on it. Glad that gave that to me. You guys are good. Oh, I still had to check out that Asylum demon. I'll do that in a minute. I was forgetting something. That is a Black Knight. Oh shit. I have to go to the ledge. Let's see if there's anything interesting up here. Oh shit, there's another Black Knight. Oh shit, that's not good. Ah, Tyrannosaurus wrecked. Man, like he hit me once and I was like, okay, well I can get a counterattack off. Then he hit me again. It's like, well, I can try to get behind him. Yes. You should play them then, Sornus, yeah. Spec. We don't have to be friends, it's okay. Bye bye. I want to go check out that other thing I just found real quick and move them back here. We're going to. Old Wolf Affairs. Perfect. I'm gonna have to call the elevator back downstairs, but that's okay. Yeah, if you get a PS4 Bloodborne, I can really recommend. I think giving Dark Souls 3 a try is worth it. If you're bored with 2. Sure. Maybe in the distant future. One day. Alright, let's go murder an Asylum Demon. Let's go probably get murdered by the Asylum Demon, but. Probably should have sent the elevator back down. I feel like this area is way too big for that to be the only enemy that's out here, right? Something else is gonna happen. Could be a dragon here. Should seem really likely that they put a dragon here. Oh, there's another poor soul. I haven't been to that gate before, have I? Is this on the other end of the map? Let me see what's over this way first, up and back way. Whoa. That's a lot of crystal lizards. There's no way I'm gonna kill all of them. So actually I think it's just one crystal lizard. And a dragon. There is I see the crystal lizard first. I don't see the dragon on the other end. Jeez. So I don't think I actually have the note up here. These are like the pilgrims trying to make their way in. Denied entry. Oh, I know where I am. Yeah, that's the other side of... Right, because we got to that edge. That's where we... found the nice turtle guy earlier. And it was a big gap that we couldn't cross. Interesting. Wonder if there's a switch to pull up the door up here. I don't know how that guy works. Seems like he's not fun time to do. Dudes with a shield and a spear give me a lot of trouble. So that's a way to go back down. I don't know if I'm actually allowed to open the thing. Probably use that to plank the asylum demon to death. But the real purpose of this is just to go back up there. Looks like that's definitely death. Well, next thing to do is to check out the dragon, see who wakes up and bites my head off. There's a good chance he's dead, but maybe he's sleepy. He's just sleeping. Nope, they might just be messing with me. No one over here somewhere? Oh, I see. Huh. Yeah, he looks pretty dead, though. Could just be for flavor. Make you think that you're gonna get destroyed when you come over here, right? Dragon Crest Shield. Greatly reduces fire damage. He is made of stone. I think that the dragons are more or less all dead now. Get at the story here. At least we haven't seen any dragons. They were, I think they were technically supposed to be all dead in Dark Souls 1 as well, like they had been killed by the rise of Gwyn and the other lords as they presided over the darkness. There were a couple exceptions, some corpses. And then part of Dark Souls 2 is the Scholar of the First Sin is trying to create new dragons. There's something fishy's going to happen here. This area is way too big. What's up, Rosif? Tail swipe. Ooh, Stray Demon. Oh man, that gets me my Havel Ring. Fantastic, perfect timing on the Havel Ring too. Been waiting to fight one of those guys for a while. Great axe. Oh hey, it's you, my buddy. Indeed. Still find this bridge to be really suspicious. Maybe they're just trying to fill you with dragon dread, right? Yeah, I guess they are. Huh. Well, right on. That was worth doing. I needed the soul of the street demon to get a ring that I've been wanting, so. And I'll try to upgrade the black bow of Ferris a little bit. The souls I'm holding on to right now. Ferris triple shot, man. We fire three arrows simultaneously. That sounds great. Alright, so Firelink, upgrade bow, get Havel Ring, and then we're gonna go for real, progress from the Champion Gundry Bonfire. We're playing Dark Souls 3 for another 40 minutes before we transition to Subblock, which today is gonna be Salt and Sanctuary, which is a Dark Souls-like game for PC, added by Serpent, followed by some Hearthstone adventures, excuse me, for Katie Cage, and then Lost Odyssey for Hunter. Which we're going to open up with like the hardest boss fight in Lost Odyssey.
Well, good, wasn't
see if we can beat it in the time allotted. Yeah, that's a really good reward, Spiky. That was just awesome. You see how high you end up going to get up there as well. So is it twinkling? No, it's regular. Okay, even better. Oh, I'm out of large titan shards. Yeah, for that. Cool.
Project Lego.
Yeah, that whole segment was super duper cool, I agree. She might still be here somewhere. Oh, right. Havel's room.
Ah, so.
Sure do. I think we want to dump the Leo ring is cool, but I don't think it's winning us battles. So it goes up to 69 now. So it's like 15% then, right? Rather than the 50% from Dark Souls 1. So we definitely wear all this without any drawbacks. Try to equip gear over here that gets me a little bit higher up. Those are 70%. Those look cool. Although, it's the highest I can go. That's the highest I can go. Okay. Did the ring next to Havel's? I think I did. I think I've been remembering to check after just about every boss. I didn't check after Champion Gundyr, though, so I'm gonna do that real quick. Oh, okay. I like all three of those. How much of a buff is it? How much extra damage do you take? So I can find the other one from Gundyr here. Halberd. Old Caster and Halberd is an hour to break poise. He said they'd never crumble as soon as the Gundyr is fit of eternal service from the beginning. As a charge. This is the one that I would use. I was going to grab it.
No, no.
So it doesn't make my stamina go up at all because I'm already at the cap, so that part's wasted. Does increase my hit points by 90 or so, and gets my equip load a little bit higher, but I think the extra damage taken probably isn't worth it. And I don't yet have the other items that I need to finish out the Solaris set, which I would like to do eventually. Alright, let's try progressing a little bit here. Still need to figure out what's going on over here. I wonder if this area is connected at all to the Flame of the First Kiln at the end of Dark Souls 1. I kind of kind of has that whole ash thing going on. I think that's what I thought the very first time that I made it into the Firelink Shrine. It reminded me of that. The fact that there's Black Knights here, that means Gwyn, right? Another one walking towards me right here, way off in the distance. I'm getting that right, yeah? The final area of Dark Souls 1, I forget the name. Some of the first kill. Ouch. Black is staggered here. Kill him with the first flame, that makes more sense. Let me try play dead. Must have play dead on there because of enemies that use it. Praise the sun. Indeed. Whoa. Freaky. What's going on here, do you think? I have no idea, and that's super exciting. Coiled sword fragment. Is that what you use to light the first bonfire? Oh, this is like a permanent homeward bone. Interesting, interesting. It's one of those in Dark Souls 2 as well. Huh. Right on. Eyes of a Firekeeper. Dude, weird. Why? Reveals horrors to the sightless Firekeeper. Set into the eyes of the first Firekeeper, and the light that was lost by all Firekeepers to come, reveals to the sightless Firekeepers things that they should never see. Interesting. I wonder where they're going with that. Blacksmith hammer. Assume that just shows it was a regular weapon, right? Shows it was a strike weapon, of course. Hammer shooter didn't realize in the hands of a blacksmith. I guess the blacksmith hammers have always been sort of a joke weapon, but I don't know if anyone's ever actually played them. We heard a screaming sound. Oops. Somewhere in here when it was in the real world. Or maybe this is the real world, you know? I still hear it over there somewhere. Hollow's ashes. Oh, is this the poor? No, just regular ashes here. Umbral ash of a hollow who faithfully served a woman only to be separated from her. With this, the shrine handmaid will prepare new items. It takes a brief glance at this thing, easily envisioned Londor, the boarding land of hollows. Still hear stuff from here. Lord, it's just here. Interesting. Keep looking around. This place is so freaky when it's dark and silent. Again, they're masters of negative space in this series. These all still say the same thing. This is so great, it's just making you wonder when you get here first, right? A lesser game would have had a cutscene that explains it when you arrive. Ludloth isn't here. Kill Aldrich. There's a couple ways out of here. I think I found this to find him. Oh no, you're good. If you've never played it before and you have guesses, you're welcome to share them. Nobody like time out someone who states that they don't know the what's happening if they get it right. As long as you make it clear that you're guessing. Filth required ahead, huh? There was something over here in the past. Not real door anymore. Actually a way for me to climb up here? Here's the answer is no. Only I had a guts, try jumping. That's not makeable, is it? I don't think so. Check what's outside the other side. Still hear that grunting sound all over the place too. Oh, you can make that jump, but it's unintended? Interesting. Unintended in like a shortcut way, or unintended in a like gets you out of bounds way? Oh, she's still here.
Well, fancy that.
I had to check the entire place except for
a lost lamb wandereth in with nary a peep from the bell. Well, thou shouldst my purpose know. What can this old handmaid provide thee?
She sells different stuff? This is Faith. Wolf Knight. Oh, it's the Artorias armor. Cool. I'm of a night tainted by the dark of the abyss. The twilight of your tassel is damp and wherever you run in, so. I'm not looking at any wolf spoilers, let me see what you mean. Cool. I don't want that ring since it's super cheap. Prince's weapon, so.
To skirt the curse's grasp, tarry not for long. 'Tis dark for now, and not a soul stirs, but remember, fires are known to fade in quiet. Or perhaps thou'rt captive already, like the poor girl.
Oh, no worries about things. If you want to discuss that stuff, you can put exclamation point hide before your chat, and that will let you discuss it with chat without me seeing it.
To skirt tap like the
Poor girl means the firekeeper who is here. Maybe the reason for coming here is to get those eyes. It seems like that's going to be bad. Yep, don't worry about it. It happens. There was still like a monstrous sound here, really. I'm sure they'll make up front of anything. Yeah, there's that cool katana guy out here, maybe. Let's see if he's still out here. Oh, that was the crunching noise I heard. Dropped his armor and leggings. I wanted to go with a knight set. Where's that? Oh, wow, that's really heavy. First, the knights served the first Lord Gwyn, and they followed him into the flame upon its linking. They became ash, but still wandered around the sun. Message did say behind, yes. Password. Yep. Oh, so like messages you place in Firelink Shrine also show up here and vice versa? That's interesting. Boreal Valley is where Anor Londo is propagable. That's where we found it, all covered in snow. Okay, I think maybe the only reason for coming here was to get that upgrade I just picked up. Maybe I can sleep behind this guy if I fall. The answer is yes. Ooh, Hornet Ring. There's the rest of the Glenlank here. Hornet Ring, is it still makes criticals better? Use critical attacks. Mask Serum is only one to serve Gwyn's Fornax, and Curse runs to Swift Death to any and all enemies of the throne. So she comes in the DLC to mourn Artorias after you meet him. Darkseid's one. You gotta make the fashion sacrifices. The reason it's heavy armor is not very good in this game, right? So they kind of changed how that works. All the real things. So let me go home, get these eyes to the Firekeeper. Make it sound like that's probably not a really good idea, but we'll see what happens when we do. And also turn in the hollow ashes that we found.
Ah, how gracious. Let this ash be. I only hope these new.
I think I have to go back there. Start from this one. Sacrifice, I think is what she just added. Maybe some weapons as well. I wish there was a new symbol, right? Gundyr's stuff. Well, that might have been just after we beat him. New weapons or armor, it looks like. Still don't have, like, lightning cannons. Or seeds, or what I need to get anything. Yep. Sure is, it's on my toe.
Ashen One, be sure to bring more.
Gets pretty cray cray during boss fights. Oh, I see, behind it. Huh. Wonder what they're going for.
Welcome home, speak.
Do you have eyes of a Firekeeper?
Ashen One, are these eyes?
They are. They're all bloodborne.
How gracious of thee, Ashen One.
No problem.
The very things we Firekeepers have been missing.
I knew what you wanted for your birthday. Oh, the music just changed.
Ashen One, my thanks for the eyes thou'st given. But Firekeepers are not meant to have eyes. It is forbidden. These will reveal through a sliver of light frightful images of betrayal. A world without fire.
That's the dark world we used in.
Ashen One, is this truly thy wish?
So the premise of the previous games has been about adding fire. I'm going to ask chat, and you guys can figure out how you want to present this to me in the least spoilery way possible. A few questions. Does this matter, what choice I make here? Is this like choosing an ending kind of a thing? Which one should I pick to get the most possible content out of Dark Souls 3? So I would decline, but maybe this puts me on a path to the endgame. Also, if this is just mandatory to progress the story, you can tell me that too. Just outright. One of these options. I guess they're just forcing you to deal with the fat roll, Spiky. It's a bummer. Take a minute here and give chat a second to reply. Best way you can explain me the consequences of this decision. So saying wish for a world without flame opens up a possible ending, but not locked into it and content's not affected.
Of course. I serve thee and will do as thou bidst.
Jeez, man.
This will be our private affair. No one else may know of this.
It's so dark and sad.
Stay thy path. Find lords to link the fire, and I will blindly tend to the flame.
Oh, man.
Until the day of thy grand betrayal.
That's so sad.
Ashen One, the eyes show a world without fire. A vast stretch of darkness. But 'tis different to what is seen when stripped of vision. In the far distance, I sense the presence of tiny flames, like precious embers, left to us by past lords, linkers of the fire. Could this be what draws me to this strangely enticing darkness? Ashen One, if thine heart should bend, kill me, and strip these eyes from my person. I will return as the firekeeper I once was. As it has always been. Ashen One, kill.
Interesting. I don't have the Dark City yet, but I don't know what that means.
Thou thy peace discover.
The music here changes. That's so crazy. All right, let me see if anything changes in here now if I go back to the Dark Realm. While I'm heading to check this out, are there other areas that I can visit now to progress the story? This is what I expected to do after beating the dancer. Well, I guess I could go back to where we fought the dancer, because there's a big chunk of area that I didn't explore there, if I'm remembering correctly. So I might go back in that direction after checking this out here. I have played Knights of the Republic 1 and 2, and they're fantastic. I think I like the first one a little bit better, but they're still both very, very, very good games. Hopefully we'll get a HD remake at some point. It was hard for me to get my wife Andrea to play Knights of the Republic just because it hasn't aged super well, you know?
Well, that what can...
She just sells Artoria stuff, so we're legit in the Abyss right now. It's been a long enough time since I played them, though. I remember the twist in both games, but that's about the extent of what I remember from them. There might be. I'm gonna go check out his bonfire real quick here soon. There's still a bunch of areas back behind here that I need to check out, so... Yeah, I know. It makes it hard for me to play games that I'm excited about now because I have to save my blind playthrough. To save myself from marriage, basically. So we're talking about going to the archive. I don't know where they are. There are a bunch of these dead pilgrims in here. Which reminded me of trying to kill the guy that murdered my pilgrim friend. Oh shit. He's a snake! I didn't realize they were snake people, potentially this whole time. Let's find Sen's fortress, right? Shit. He might just look like the turtle people and actually have been a snake this whole time. Pointless area. Yeah. So this is back towards the abyss. You can see my stats up in the top corner. I started as a... Does it even show you in this game? Warrior. I just want to get as much endurance as possible. Playing with the spear. It's been fun for me so far. Right? That hard read. Flarewing, I don't remember what it was that I said I was gonna do. Can you remind me? I'll still take credit for it, since apparently I said it. The only thing I can remember is moving backwards from where we fought him and exploring the area back here a little bit more. Blade of the... I don't think there's any other exits from this room, for example. Oh yeah, go get the, Oh, I thought that would just be like a covenant or something. Didn't think that would even kind of be important. Can go do it real quick, though. Aw, really? Really? My soul's bad. He's in this... kindled status or anything. Running, running, running. Thanks for the commentary, sir. Really appreciate that. Said Irithyll Dungeon. Oh jeez. I don't remember how to get to it from here though. I don't know if I wanna explore the whole place. It might be near there's an elevator near this bonfire. I'll go try taking that down. Pray for rain. I'm playing for about 10 more minutes, so not a ton of time stuff coming. Maybe it was the elevator. I feel like this just went down by where the giant previously was though, right? Oh jeez, I don't think I remember where it was exactly. Is there more than one elevator that I had opened up? Where's the end? Yeah, just one. Other elevator shortcut. Close to the room of the billion jailers, okay. I can remember that. It was like before the room with the billion jailers there, right? Take north of that. You go to the boss door and work backwards from there. Let's see if I get through running this one. Just gonna run, run, run. Don't think just go it up. Aw, you bastard. Yeah, that's probably what I'll do. Because I can kind of do that for free now, can I? Let me see where this spits us out. I forget where this was. Not near where I need to be, so we'll do that. Yeah, so it's just on the other side of the billion jailer room. Okay. That's cool. I've run through that room before, so it would be okay if we try that. This is a place for giants. Fortunately, it has some nice human-sized ladders. Appreciate that. So there's a gargoyle on this bridge I don't want to mess with. Hell room. Hopefully they stop chasing me. Aha. So the theory is here. Do this Path of the Dragon. It might be that we have to face them, or it could be sitting directly on one of these guys here. Dragon. I guess there's a thing we can see right in there. Cool. Yeah, we got here earlier and we saw a gesture acquired ahead, so I knew we had to come back here. I just didn't remember exactly where it was in the rest of the dungeon. So sneaky. Oh, it's a new area? Oh, that's surprising. I thought it was just going to be like an NPC would show up and it would give me a covenant or something. Cool. That's a well-hidden thing, because it's something that you could potentially figure out, especially if you got here and you saw a gesture required ahead, you know? Where did we get the, remind me where we got the dragon gesture? I don't remember. Whoa. The bell is ringing here. Interesting. I wonder where they're going with it. Oh, awesome. Arch Dragon Peak. There's another Snake Man. Okay. That particular use of an enemy is important for story perspectives. Why would we meet these guys and not another enemy, you know? Oh, shit. Almost got snecked in the face again. Bonfire. Double. That's better. I'll fight two of those guys at once. Oh, okay. So it feels like progression from there. Gotcha. Thanks. No. Surprised this place appears to be good progression. There's a couple ways around. Okay, that's a statue of a dragon, at least for now. Lightning gem. It seems they gate access to lightning weapons later in the game. first one I found, Al. Snack. There was another one behind me that whole time that I didn't even notice. I'll try to get out of here before we die with no bonfire. Traption does not move. I love how slowly their head retracts. That's awesome. This is so cool. I'm wondering what they're implying with this whole area, you know? Shit. Don't die. Gotta get a bonfire before we can die. Another one. There we go. One at a time I can handle. Big groups of them. Trigger. Hey, there's a bonfire. Fantastic. Cool. So I think that's a good stopping point to switch over to sub block here. If you're here for Dark Souls, it will return. We're actually going to be playing it again tomorrow. In the same time block, so keep an eye on the schedule of the stream. We'll be playing Dark Souls 3 at least 1 or 2 days per week until we beat it. I'll be back in a few minutes with Salt and Sanctuary, Serpent's sub-block game, which is also inspired by this series. I haven't played it or watched any of it yet, so brand new for me. Hey, thanks for the host, Kodiak. Appreciate that. How was your return to Final Fantasy XIV today? Did you try any more of the Palace of the Dead? And Kodiak for a while this morning. Transfer to Ultros, man. Play with you in the morning before I go live. Be fun. Be right back.